Monday, January 13, 2020. Hello, everyone. You're watching the press review on Journal du Cameroun Television. Today, we begin with the lone daily bilingual newspaper, The Guardian Post, which headlines on Fru Ndi's reaction to the repeated kidnap and burning of properties of the SDF supporters in the northwest region of Cameroon. The paper says, February twin elections, Fru Ndi accuses CPDM of conniving with Amba boys to frustrate the Social Democratic Front Party, insist persistent kidnappings, intimidation and burning of houses of SDF officials is a calculated move by the ruling CPDM party to win the SDF strongholds at the upcoming municipal and legislative elections. More on this on page 3 of the Guardian Post newspaper, published this Monday, 13 January 2020. The paper equally writes on the port city of Limbe, preparing to host for the very first time the National Maritime and Ports Day due for tomorrow Tuesday, January the 14th, 2020. We take the Sun newspaper to talk back attacks on SDF officials in the northwest region. The paper headlines, elections in the northwest and southwest, SDF bearing brunt of separatist fury in reaction to the repeated attacks by separatists on SDF officials. Fru Ndi, the party chairman, says they are missing their target. The paper presents a lengthy chat with Fru Ndi on all these attacks, plus a report on him flying abroad for an alleged long stay on page 2 of its Monday, January the 13th, 2020 edition. The same story finds voice on the Star newspaper, which has as main headline, 30 days to the twin elections, Fru Ndi leaves the country, tells the Star he is traveling for further treatment after his last torture by separatist fighters in Bamenda, accuses some Northwest elite of targeting the SDF by sponsoring the burning of homes and kidnapping of militants. The paper equally highlights he revealed he has received life-threatening messages from Amba boys if he dares enter the Northwest region, and advances this as the reason why he has not been to Bamenda. Southwest and Northwest robbed in the sharing of the 2020 budget, banners the Eden newspaper, which reports that the two regions which have continued to bear the heaviest brunt of the country's poor governance system is yet another victim of the general discrimination in the 2020 public investment budget. The paper says statistics from the investment budget allocation, the PIB, shows largely inequitable distribution of the 2020 PIB, with gross discrimination described by some observers as robbing Peter to pay Paul. The paper adds that analysts say it may strengthen separatists with more argument. Details on these budget allocations on page 3. We end this press review with The Voice newspaper, which says that African lawyers have pricked British Prime Minister Boris Johnson on injustices in southern Cameroon. It presents a letter addressed to Boris Johnson by the president of the African Bar Association, Anibal Waifo, part of which reads, "We French Cameroon are not annexationists. If our brothers of the British zone wish to unite with independent Cameroon, we are ready to discuss the matter with them, but we would on a footing of equality." According to The Voice newspaper, the letter digs up clear facts, data and figures that will be vital in addressing the root causes and seeking a lasting solution to the southern Cameroon's crisis, which according to the African lawyers has claimed 12,000 lives. And that does it for what the papers had to say today. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.